Hey everyone, I'm Sam with Rokoko, and today we're going to be walking through a quick little workflow of the Rokoko two-camera AI mocap solution. Specifically in this workflow, we're going to talk about how you can use equipment you may already have instead of having to go purchase two webcams. In this demo, I'll be using the built-in camera on my laptop with my iPhone synced to my laptop over Wi-Fi. And this is all free, right? I already had the camera that was in my laptop. I already have an iPhone in my pocket. I'm ready to go. That's all you need. So we do recommend that you use two wired cameras or webcams for the Rokoko two-camera AI tool. And that's because with wired cameras, you won't run into any Wi-Fi issues or potential lag issues, which you can run into with this workflow. And if you're getting laggy video from your iPhone over Wi-Fi, this is not going to work for you. And that's something that you'll have to, you know, sort out beforehand. But whenever I've used it, it's worked great. So this is a very viable workflow for using the two-camera AI mocap tool from Rokoko Vision. You can also find really detailed documentation that covers everything we're gonna do today in the links down below. It also has recommended browsers, recommended webcams, all important information if you're planning on using Rokoko Vision 2 camera. And so I recommend that you go and you check that out either before you get started or, you know, as you're working with the tools. So without further ado, let's jump into it and make some mocap. For this demo, I'm gonna be using a free app called Camo, which I just downloaded on the App Store. I'm also on a PC laptop, so this works for connecting an iPhone to a PC, which is really great, but the same workflow should work with continuity if you're on all Mac, or if you're on Android, you can also use Camo. And there's a few other apps in the documentation that we've provided that we recommend checking out as well if the Camo solution doesn't work for you. To start, I've downloaded the Camo app to my phone and I've just created a free account. And I've also downloaded the PC software client. So here you can see I've got Camo open on my computer and it's currently picking up my built-in laptop camera. However, we need to connect our iPhone. On my laptop, I'll hit the plus button up at the top left to add a device. So I'll open up my iPhone app and then I'll hit the little Wi-Fi with a plus sign to connect to my computer. And it will automatically connect my PC and my iPhone as long as you're on the same Wi-Fi network. As soon as I connect, you can see it says on my iPhone that the device is currently inactive. And that's just because I need to switch my device on my laptop from the built-in camera to the iPhone. Then I'll go and I'll set up my iPhone on a little iPhone mount that I have and position it towards where I'll be recording. So now we can actually make some motion capture. I'll go to vision.rokoko.com and I will log into Rokoko Vision. And then I'll select create and then the dual camera option. So you do need a plus subscription to use the dual camera AI mocap. And you can find out more about those options in our full Rokoko Vision video, which is in the description below. As soon as we get into our dual cam tool, we can see both of our video feeds. And you might need to allow access to the cameras in your browser. And also remember that you need to use a supported browser like Chrome or Safari. This time I'm using Chrome. I'll make sure that I fit between the lines. So I actually had to go and adjust my laptop camera a little bit to make sure I did. And then I'll hit calibration. So this is a super quick process, but it requires you to print out the calibration sheet. Again, you can find links for that in the documentation or in the description below. It is possible to use an iPad. I cannot recommend this because it really is not the way that you should be doing a calibration. You really need to print out that printout on a standard sheet of paper because the dimensions of the printout matter. But all that being said, I have used just my iPad with the PDF of the printout open on the iPad. It worked great. I cannot officially recommend it. You might get weird results with it, but it did work for me. So take that as you will. In this demo, I did print out a calibration sheet, which is what we recommend, and I mounted it to some cardboard to keep it nice and flat. And then I just go and I do my simple calibration. After I finish that for both cameras, I'll be asked to do a floor calibration, which you do by simply placing the QR code for the floor calibration on the floor. And so now we'll move on to actually record. So as I said in the beginning of the video, one issue you can run into when using an iPhone for video over Wi-Fi is lag. And if you are getting lag, which you'll be able to see with the naked eye, you know, as you look at both images, if you are getting lag, it's not going to work. right? Your both cameras need to be synced up. So perhaps it might be a weak Wi-Fi signal. Maybe you need to move closer to the router. For me, it worked perfectly. You can actually see I did get a little bit of lag right before I started recording, but then everything caught up and before it started, and so it was totally fine. It's always worked great for me. It worked great for me in this one, and as you can see, we even picked up some fast-paced motions and we stayed perfectly synced. So once we hit stop, we will get our synced clips put into a timeline. And this is another opportunity to see if you did have that lag issue. And if you did, you're gonna have to re-record. But having these two clips in the timeline will allow you to trim out the specific mocap that you want. Usually you just use it to remove the ends of the clip where you walk out of frame back to the computer. But in this clip, I just left it as is and I just hit turn into animation. So at this point, you're pretty much done. You can hit the home button and you can go and record more mocap while you wait for your clip to process. There's no need to stay on the processing screen while it gets to 100%. Normally I create a couple different takes during this time, and by the time I get back to my first take, it's all been processed and the mocap is ready to view. And if I jump back into this take, you can see it's almost done and here we go. We now get to see our motion capture, and this looks fantastic, right? We have no drift, all the jumping and the turning away from the camera still looks perfecto. And I can go and I can download the clip directly from my browser. And you can see here, if we open it up, we have a solid FBX to bring into our software and retarget. Or what we can do is open up Rokoko Studio and take a look at this mocap in there and get a bunch more options. So let's do that now. I'll open up Rokoko Studio and I'm gonna log into the same account that I recorded my mocap in. And here you can see when you get to the homepage of Rokoko Studio, we have this Rokoko Vision project that was created automatically for us. And this is where all of our mocap from all of our Rokoko Vision takes will show up. If we jump in, you might need to do a little syncing to bring the new mocap take in. But once in the project, you can see that I very messily haven't named any of my previous recordings, so they all appear as untitled. However, our animation is gonna be the newest one at the top. And I also have a character already imported from Mixamo into this scene to retarget our animation onto. Our mocap from our recording is looking amazing. And because we're in Rokoko Studio, I can edit the foot contacts if there are issues. This little jump, for instance, I can tweak to look a little bit better. The solid bars down here on the timeline represent when our feet are actually on the ground. So if I just move these bars around a little bit, there we go. We have a nice clean jump. So as good as this looks, another thing I can do is turn off locomotion entirely. And I can do that by clicking on the little wand down at the bottom left. So this will mean that your feet are no longer solidly connecting with the ground. You're gonna have foot sliding, you're gonna have slippage, but the advantage is that the rest of the mocap from the feet up is looking a little bit better and much more natural. And that's because we're not doing that foot contact processing on this take anymore. So if you don't need to see the feet of your character in your scene, I do recommend turning off locomotion and just framing out the feet, because the rest of the mocap take is gonna look even better. Another advantage of opening the mocap in Rokoko Studio is that you can import custom characters and retarget your mocap live onto them. Currently, you can import Unreal Skeleton characters or Mixamo characters and a few other skeleton types, and you can find more information on this process in the videos and the links in the description below. But let's add this character that I auto-rigged on Mixamo. We'll import it in, and then we can drag it onto the highlighted actor profile in our scene, and we've got our mocap retargeted onto our character, and we can get this feedback live on how it looks. And we can even go in and make edits to the arm positioning or the neck positioning or the shoulder positioning to maybe make the character look even better or fix some clipping issues. Once we're done and satisfied with our motion capture, of course, we can go and export the mocap out to use in whatever our preferred 3D software is. So there you go. That's a quick little video showing you how to use some equipment that you probably already have in your house, you know, a built-in laptop camera and the iPhone that's just in my pocket, and set it up using free apps from the App Store to get this great result using the Rokoko Vision dual camera solution. Please put any questions you have about this workflow in the comments down below, or you can check out some of our other videos on Rokoko Vision or the documentation, which is really fantastic for this tool and probably has the answers to any questions you might have. We hope you found this useful. We're really proud of this AI mocap tool and how well it performs, but we do understand that it's a lot for people to go out and grab two webcams, you know, grab a USB extender. It's nice to be able to do this with tools that you just have already, you know, in your office or whatever. Again, the phone in your pocket, and you don't need to go and grab any other equipment to do it. Hopefully you found this helpful. We'll see you in the next video. Go make some motion capture. Bye-bye.